First Corinthians chapter 11. Paul had been with Jesus, and but as he gives some instructions about baptism, kind of brings us to the point of humility and where we are when we observe the Lord's Supper. And I just want to read you the latter verses of this message as Paul brings it to this church. And he said, for in the 11th chapter, 1 Corinthians, verse 23, he said, "For I have received of the Lord," and isn't that good? He got this firsthand. "For I have received of the Lord, which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, 'Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.' And after the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament of the blood. This do we as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come." Now, the rest of it is where what brings us to where we are tonight. And he said in that 27th verse, "Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord." Now, Paul would do that because that's who he was. And that's how much he loved Jesus. And that's how strong he knew this Last Supper was as far as Jesus was concerned. And then he said, "But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when ye come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, that ye come not together unto condemnation. And the rest will I set in order when I come." In other words, he's saying, when I get there, I'll show you how it's done. And I'm glad he did, and I'm glad we know how to do it. And I praise the Lord for that tonight. Let me pray. Father, this is holy. We're standing on holy ground in Jesus' name. And I ask you to bless everything that's fixing to happen in this place. We're going to pass out the bread in remembrance of this Last Supper. We're going to pass out the drink. We're going to drink of that cup. And on this same night, you was betrayed. You knew it. You knew it was coming. You had told him it was going to happen. But you went to that cross because you love me. And how I praise your name for that. So I ask you, and I invite every born-again Christian sitting in this very room right now to examine their heart and to be a part of this Lord's Supper. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you as we observe this ordinance of our faith. We've already observed baptism, and now we observe the Lord's Supper. And I thank you for this wonderful privilege. Would you bless us during this time with your awesome presence in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Would you prepare the table, please? It said on the night before he was betrayed, at the conclusion of the feast of the Passover, which he and his disciples were celebrating, he took the bread and he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples and said, "This is my body, which is given for you." Would you pass out the bread, men, please? Thank you. Adam, would you pray, please?
Heavenly Father, we're gathered here tonight to partake of the Lord's Supper, to take communion with fellow believers. Lord, I just want to say thank you for giving your Son for us. You said to take this bread and to do that in remembrance of you. Lord, we're headed into the Easter season. This is Palm Sunday, the day that we celebrate you coming in on the donkey, on that triumphal entry. Lord, we're headed for our Easter Sunday, which is the miracle of all miracles, when the grave couldn't hold you anymore. Lord, you rode into town knowing that you were headed for that cross, knowing that your body was going to be bruised and battered and put on the cross to die, Lord, and you've done that because you loved us. So, Lord, we thank you, and just bless each and every one of us tonight as we keep our total focus on you, as we take this bread in remembrance of you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
This is the bread which came down from heaven. Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eateth of this bread shall live forever. Let's eat of this bread. That same night, our Lord took the cup, and having blessed it, he gave it to his disciples and said, "This is my blood, which was shed for you. Would you pass out the cup, please?" Thank you. Joseph, would you pray, please?
Father, I thank you for what this drink represents. I thank you that it represents your perfect blood.
Amen.
And that without it, there's no remission for sin. I thank you that it represents a brutal death. Thank you that it represents a new covenant, that we no longer have to go through a human mediator, but we can come directly to you.
Amen.
I'm so thankful and so humbled by your sacrifice, and that in fellowship with you and in remembrance for what you have done in my life personally, I get to look back and fellowship with you tonight as I take of this drink as an example of your blood. For those of us here tonight, I pray that we would never look past the importance of your blood and what that means for us, and that we would never take it lightly, but we would understand that from the blood of a perfect Savior is the reason that we get to take this communion. Thank you for the blessing that you have bestowed upon us, and may you bless us tonight as we do this in remembrance of you. In Christ's name, amen.
Join me as we drink of this cup. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without the shedding of blood is no remission. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. For as oft as you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes. Let's pray. Lord, you are holy, and in Jesus' name, we have just a small portion of that supper. We've sensed that atmosphere the very best that we can, and we can't even imagine the pressure of that evening on those precious disciples. And we can't imagine the pressure of that evening as you have announced you will be betrayed. And they're all sitting thinking, is it I? Is it I? And Lord, we've all been guilty during our lives as Christians of not doing everything we should do. We've been cold and indifferent. We've been away from you. But you're so gracious with your love, Jesus. You take us back when we fail and come short. So I ask you tonight to forgive us of all of our sins, and that you've cleansed us through this time of the Lord's Supper. And I pray as we prepare for an invitation, if there is anybody in this building that was totally affected by this time of the Lord's Supper, and they just want to come to the altar and get closer to you, they want to praise you for the opportunity to observe this moment, I just pray that that's what this altar is for. If there's somebody here and they don't know Jesus as their personal Savior, I'm glad they got to witness this, and they see the reality, they sense in the atmosphere of this very room what this means to us. And I thank you for the baptisms that we observe when you came out of that water, Jesus. The Heavenly Father said, behold, this is my beloved Son, whom I'm well pleased. So I pray if there's somebody here and they're lost, they'll realize, hey, I'm here to get saved. And they'll come to this altar and invite you to come into their life. And then the next time they take the Lord's Supper, it'll mean something very special to them, as it has to each one of us. So I ask you to honor this invitation with your presence. Anybody here under the direction of the Holy Spirit just needs to come to this altar. That's what this time is for. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Stand with us.